Hey, what's up? How you doing? It's another beautiful day. I'm so much excited to be here because today we're going to be speaking something really unimaginable, because all the time we're always thinking about several things you need to do when you need to start a business. But this time I've reversed the roles. I'm going to be speaking about the top seven things that you should not do. The seven top things not to do when starting a business in the year 2020. Not to do, that's a key word. We always know what to do. We need to do plan this, but what are some of the things that we need to avoid so that we have a successful startup? And I don't want to take much time. Let me just go straight to the points. Number one, picking the wrong business. All the time we are starting businesses, but have you ever asked yourself, am I rushing to gain money or am I creating a solution for something? Look at the most successful businesses and the people who started the most successful businesses. For example, Alibaba, Alibaba.com, Jack Ma. What made him a billionaire was not the aspect that he was thinking about making money. It's the aspect that he wanted to build a solution for people so that people can sell their products in an easier way. He can be able to connect the sellers and the buyers on one platform, and then they can buy and they can sell. And all that he got was just a commission. So he had a solution in mind. Look at Mark Zuckerberg, the owner of Facebook. When he was starting Facebook, all that he had in mind was to connect people, to connect families, to connect relatives, friends, and all that. And you can see, what are my friends doing at this time? Where are they right now? What are they enjoying? What are their sad times? And that aspect of creating a solution made him a billionaire. Look at I was watching a small documentary about these guys who started YouTube. They were formerly working with PayPal, and now when they broke off, they wanted to start a platform whereby people can share videos. They can do some videos and then they can share on a certain platform so that their friends can be able to watch and even give a comment or something like that. And when these guys started that platform, one thing that they were saying is that they had no idea of how they'll make money. They just started off. They put the platform, people were uploading videos, and after some time, after almost a year or something, is when companies started approaching them, telling them, we are seeing so many people are watching the videos on your platform. Can we advertise A, B, C, D? Can we advertise this and that? And with that, they got an idea. We did not know we can start advertising using these videos that we have. At the middle of some segments, we can place in advertisements and make money. And they became billionaires. So please don't pick the wrong business. Don't start the business with money in your mind. Start with a solution in your mind and you're going to make a lot of money. So change the world and inspire others. Point number two, making the perfect plan. This is another mistake people always do. You always try to make the perfect plan. You plan, how am I going to make money? How am I going to do this? Who am I going to work with? What am I going to achieve? Who will help me here? Where will I place my job? So many plans. You plan and plan and plan and plan. And at the end of the day, the planning does not give you business. What gives you business is the actual work that you're doing down there. Now, let me explain very well. Have you seen some people who keep on saying, in our estate, there's no dry cleaner. I think I will be starting a dry cleaner in our estate. And all the time he's saying, I'm starting a dry cleaner. So when I start it, this is where I'll put it. These are the workers I'll be with. This is ABCD. You keep on planning. And then at the end of the day, you discover that somebody else already started a dry cleaner at the same area that you wanted to start, and you keep on telling people, that was my idea, I could have been the one who has done this and that. That is where you go wrong. Stop planning. You can never have the perfect plan. Trust you me, you can never have the perfect plan. Just plan a little bit and start. Your customers are going to adjust you accordingly. They will tell you, this dry cleaner is not really good. Could you bring something else which can be doing, maybe selling all the clothes or something, because people want that. Your customers will start tilting you to the area that you're supposed to be doing. Number three, spending money. If I give you ₱1,000,000 right now, you'll find a million ways to spend the money. You'll spend money in this way, building websites, business cards. You will find maybe making your office to be so beautiful. All those things, they matter, yes, in business. But that's not the actual sense of business. All that your business needs is your time and commitment and finding the customers and listening to them and finding what can I be able to do so that I can create sales. Business cards, websites, all those things, they are very good, but they don't give you the actual business. That is the 80% of the junk things that you do in your business, which will only just bring you a good color, a good looking office, but you're not making the money. And that's where most of the Kenyans do. You go to the offices are really busy, people are on the laptops, the secretaries are there, you think they are doing anything, but they are doing nothing. But the actual guys who are making the money are out there looking for customers, making phone calls, connecting, interacting, and telling customers, this is what we need to do, this is what we need to do. Customer ABCD, please, can I give you service, this and that. That is the actual business. Concentrate on what matters. Don't concentrate on what does not matter. Don't spend money. Just work, talk to people, and invest your time. Point number four, doing it alone. Nobody's a loner. Nobody is a loner. Nobody is a loner. Nobody's an island. There's no way you will make a million shillings or 2 million or 10 million shillings all by yourself by doing something that is giving you maybe 100,000 a month. You yourself, you don't have more than 24 hours. You only have 24 hours. And if you need to make more money, you need to leverage more. You need to have so many people behind you who are supporting the same vision that you have. You can have employers or employees. You can have volunteers. You can have interns. You can have as many people as possible who will support your vision and who will support exactly what you want to do. Because if you don't do that, there's no way you're going to make it bigger all by yourself. It's not possible. I once went to a certain restaurant back in the village somewhere, and I found this restaurant. It's been there for so many years. People are some old guy and his wife. They're the owner of the restaurant. So you find the husband is in the kitchen cooking, and still he's the one serving the food, and the wife is in the kitchen trying to wash utensils, and she's also serving the food. The only two of them, one is serving, one is washing the dishes, cooking. You can't do everything by yourself. Look at the most exclusive hotels in this country. You will never even know who is the owner. Because why? They have leverage. They have people, accountants, secretaries, this and that, gardeners. You can be everywhere by yourself. All you need is to have a good plan and a good hierarchy of how you're going to delegate duties so that you can create a bigger, massive wealth than you could have done it by yourself. This is one aspect of business. Don't do it alone. Build a team. Point number five. Don't jump into the wrong partnerships. Partnerships, when you start in business, many people just jump in. I found this guy in a mall. We talked about the business. I want to bring the things from Dubai or China so that I can sell downtown River Road. And then all of a sudden, this guy tells you, wow, I know somebody in China. This person is my friend. And then all of a sudden, you tell him, can we partner? We can become business partners. Come on. Partnership is like marriage. This is somebody you need to know their values. You need to know what they like, what they don't like. What do they believe in? Do they believe in the same vision that you have? Or is just because they know somebody in China, that one makes them to be a perfect partner? No, it doesn't work that way. Because the moment you get into this partnership with them, it's like you're marrying them. You, for good, for worse. The business goes down, you're down together. They won't leave you. When the business is up, they won't start making excuses and spending anyhowly, because that's not your vision. Your vision is to grow, to become bigger, and to reinvest the money. These people will just make 1,000 shillings or 100,000 Kenya shillings, and all of a sudden they're in Mombasa on holiday. That's their vision. They're seeing here. So before you partner with someone, check their vision, their values. What do they believe in? What do they want to achieve? And so forth. And after that, you can now decide, am I going to partner with this person or not? Am I going to be with this person or not? You can start with small tasks here and there before you give them everything that you have. Point number six, do not operate in a bubble. Don't operate in a bubble. What do I say? Operating in a bubble is just doing things because you're doing. I'm starting a business because I have to start a business. I'm starting a business because others are starting a business. You're not researching. You're not doing anything. You're not reading. You're not understanding where you're getting into. I want to sell glasses like this one. And just because I saw Optica selling glasses and the shop is full, I decide tomorrow I'm starting a company of selling glasses. Understand first. Watch other people's videos. Understand what are they saying about this business. Read books. Read journals. Read newsletters. Understand what are these people, what are the challenges that they are going through. What is it exactly that they are, what profit are they making and what losses are they making? There's no way you're going to start a business out of the blues without doing a small research. Don't operate from the bubble. Let me give a good example. So many friends of mine keep on telling me that in Kenya, I think the best business that you can do right now is selling clothes, secondhand clothes and new clothes from Turkey, others from Uganda and so forth. And somebody just wakes up one day and decides, I'm heading to Uganda to buy clothes and come and sell. Have you done your research? Are you operating on a bubble? Do you know the profits and the losses? Do you know the challenges that these people are facing before they bring the luggage here? Do you know the taxes which you have to pay? Do you know the profit margin? Read books, watch videos. YouTube is here. All the time I'm posting videos on YouTube. Watch videos from not only me, but from every other person who can inform you on your niche. Point number 7. Starting with a service before a product. That is the best thing that you should always do. Let me just reverse it. Many people start with a product before they come to the service, and that is where they also go wrong. If you want to start a successful business, first focus on the service part. Don't focus on the product. What am I talking about? You want to start selling cars. There's no way you're going to buy cars from Japan and bring them in a yard. You don't know exactly how this business operates. And all of a sudden you want to be making millions of profit. Forget even about the cars. That's a bigger job. Selling mobile phones. You want to sell the latest iPhones. And then you open a shop here. And all of a sudden you put a lot of products, stock and everything. And you want people to buy. How are they going to buy from you? And you don't even know how the business works. So the best thing to do is start it like a service. Become a broker. Go and talk to an Apple company or talk to some dealer of cars and tell them, can you give me the price of your cars? This car is 900,000, this is 800,000, this is 1.2, this is what. Take their photos, go on social media or wherever, open a small website, advertise, make yourself so big. Connect and tell people, this car, I'm selling it at 1 million shillings. If back in your mind, you know, the guy told you at 900,000. You're just doing a markup. Alright, the car is not yours and all that. So you advertise it at 1 million shillings. You get the client and you tell him, hey, this is the car. Take him to the yard. Connect the buyer and the seller. Get your 100,000 cut. You've just given a service. You have not given the actual, you have not bought the car. You have not done anything. You have not invested anything. You've just connected. Service is one thing which you can start without any money. When I was in Mombasa, I was doing apartment business. And then the first time that I started doing this apartment business, it was a little bit hard because I didn't know what to do. But I had one idea in mind. I just mark up other people's houses and apartments, and then I get my cut. The house is not mine. The Airbnb is not mine. Everything that I'm selling, the apartment is not mine. Person just comes and tells me, this is my house, I'm giving it 5,000 shillings a day, a night or whatever. And they come and just advertise the same house at 8,000 shillings. When I advertise at 8,000 shillings, I get a customer, I bring them here, I connect the buyer and the seller. Or even sometimes they will never even know who was the seller of the house. They will never know because I just bring you here, I have the key from the other person. When the client comes, give them the key and all that. The money is given to me, 8,000 shillings. I give the owner 5,000 shillings. You're done. That is service. Service. You spend no money. You enjoy the fruits and labor of others while you're seated back and relaxing. By the time you understand this business very well, by the time you understand how it works, now you can have your own house, your own yard, your own everything. And bring your cars, bring your products, your iPhones, your everything, and sell, because already you have the customer flow, already you have everything flowing, and your life will never be the same again. Oh my friend, so I'm so much excited today because it's been a wonderful time. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Just give it a thumbs up, something little, and give it a comment. Tell me also what you may want me to speak on in the next episode. And as well, you can subscribe down there. There's a button. You can subscribe and also hit the notification button so that you don't miss any video that I'll be posting, because it's going to be fire. 2020 is going to be fire. See ya. God bless you and have a blessed time.